have to discuss something about the lifestyle modification in type 2 diabetes mellitus. We all talk about diabetes and lifestyle modification. The lifestyle modification has to be a comprehensive lifestyle modification. Lifestyle modification include physical activity, diet. What happens? People talk about the medications and they say ki we are doing regular exercise, we are keeps on the taking diet control, we don't eat anything. But this is not a good thing. We have to see what we need to take in the diet. And diet is very simple. People says we don't take sweets. If you go at somebody's place, you will take a cup of tea without sugar. You will not take rasgulla or any sweets. But at the same time, you take namkins, that fried items, thinking that it doesn't contain sugar or it will not disturb your diabetes. But see, one teaspoon of sugar gives you 40 calories, but at the same time, one teaspoon of oil or ghee will gives you 100 calories. That is 2.5 times more than the sugar. So you take more calories. It's the calorie count which matters a lot. It's not the only sweet. We have to avoid the refined things or sugar. So try to avoid fried and deep fried things. Try to avoid samosas, namkins and all the things. Take much of fruits. We can follow a rule of 100, 50 and 25. You can say 100% no to sugar, jam, jelly, butters. We can curtail down our oil consumption by 50%. And we can replace 25% of our food, present food, with the fruits and salads. And during the physical activity, most of the nowadays life's outdoor games are stopped. Most of the time people and the children, young children, play the computer games or the games on their mobiles. So there is almost no physical activity. People keep on sitting and standing for hours together. So we should have at least physical activity of 150 minutes per week, at least 5 days in a week in divided. So this is very important. Or if most of the people talk about it's not possible for them to go for the morning walk, so they can go to the evening walk also, and it can be divided. In between your work culture, after every 2 to 3 minutes, you can have a break of 10 minutes and you can do exercise. So whatever your job is there, your activity should be divided and you can modulate according to that. So by manipulating the data shows with comprehensive lifestyle modification, we can reduce HbA1c by more than 1%. That is much better than a drug with most of the drugs. So without lifestyle modification, nothing will help. So this should be the first part of treatment in any diabetic patient. And along with the comprehensive means also weight moderation. It doesn't mean the only drug. If a person is having obese, we can have a weight reducing strategy also. So by reducing weight, we can also control the HbA1c. It has been seen by reduction of 3 kg of weight, we can reduce HbA1c by 1%. So we have to do the moderation of the weight also. So in summary, I would like to say lifestyle modification should be the core and should be the first, and it should be the part of each and every regime of the treatment of a diabetic patient. And without that, we cannot do it. Thank you very much.
Insights from the world's best medical minds. You are watching therightdoctors.com.